Hurt. Okay. Now, okay, in your package of goodies that you've gotten, there are two gaskets. They are of two different thicknesses. You can place the thicker of the two inside the sound head, sound box. Now I am actually waiting for an appropriate time to take the stuff out of the vinegar soup here. Okay, at this point now I will take the blue washcloth. Always use a blue one. Grab out some of your parts, the needle bar. Give that a good wiping off. Forget the blue washcloth. Also have Q-tips at the ready. You might take some Brasso for the head of your clamping screw. But, you know, clean off your set screw, your needle screws, little needle bearings. One thing I wonder, I have some watch oil. I might put a drop of watch oil on the points of those needle bearings, if I remember to do it, depending on how frustrated I get on the reassembly part of this. This is a Columbia number 6 reproducer, by the way. You won't see any numbers anywhere on it, but it is a Columbia number 6 reproducer, sound box, whatever. I think that depends on what part of the country you live in, whether a can of soda is a can of soda or a can of pop. I thought that was so strange when I visit my cousins in Ohio. Let's have a can of pop. Oh, okay. Pop. Meaning, of course, soda pop. And that microscopic little back screw. Now that's going to be a challenge because you have to melt a little dab of beeswax to seal that. If you lose that little baby, you are going to be crying like a pig. Okay, that's a little lock washer. I didn't realize those are lock washers on there, and I understand why. Good thing for you guys, I'm cutting a lot of this dead space out of this video, because I know it's going to run long. That's the washer for the diaphragm, the needle bar and the diaphragm. This is a smaller washer for the needle bar through the diaphragm. Okay, let's clean some schmutz off of that. Okay, we're ready for a reassemble, except for I wanted to get the inside of the retaining ring. Hit that with some Brasso, clean that up. Okay, pause the camera and I will return. Now the fun begins. Get your new diaphragm and place on your, I'm going to call this thing what it is. It's a cantilever, folks. Those of you with high fidelity turntables know what a cantilever is. Carefully place that, and now the fun stuff begins. Get that little washer on there. And now you have to get that microscopic nut back on there. There's no easy way to do this, friends. Okay, now this is the point where I'm most likely to use some colorful language, or possibly not. I really don't want to leave any fingerprints on the inside of this. I do not have microscopic nut drivers for this. Well, it looks like the power of the universe wants me to do this correctly. Thank you, God. Look at that. It should be as snug as it was before. I don't know how to relate this to you in inch pounds or torque settings, but I replaced transistors in a stereo amplifier and I told you to put them in snuggly wuggly. So put them in snuggly wuggly. Now, I did not get any beeswax with this kit, but I just happen to have some beeswax left over from a previous diaphragm replacement. Yes, this is the same size. Good thing I checked. Okay, now, the point is now to get a dab of beeswax on there. This thing works by air pressure, folks, and the less number, the fewer number of leaks that you have in your air transmission from the diaphragm through to the horn, the better. And beeswax is a means of sealing that. And I've sort of gotten a patented way of doing melting that beeswax. By the way, your little needle bearings here, make sure you don't have any brasso or dust in there. Aligning the needle bearings is going to be probably a bigger trick than this. Okay, now let me set up for the melting of the beeswax scene. Hopefully I can do this in one take. Remember, you have lock washers, two lock washers, two lock nuts, two needle bearings, and the big frame of this. This also has to go in there, so this has to finagle in there as well. And when you put your gasket, oh boy, you'll see. Just sit tight, believe me, it'll work. Now, friends, if this arrangement looks a little strange to you, it's because it is. Yes, folks, that's correct. I'm using a soldering iron to melt the beeswax. Now, you should know that these mica diaphragms, these are mineral. These are rock, okay? They are stone of a sort. Don't worry about getting them hot. What I would worry about is getting solder on your antique cantilever. Take a toothpick and finagle one of these little dots of beeswax in position. Heat that until it should melt rather quickly. And it falls off to the side. Try to urge it back into position. There you go. Isn't that lovely? Isn't that a smart little idea that I invented, by the way? And you have to pay me royalties for this idea. No, you don't. I'm kidding you. Half of this video is kidding you. It's all about kidding you. Okay. Oh, looky, I made a little invention. I made a mica diaphragm top. I don't think they used beeswax originally on this soundbox. I don't know what they used, and there are remnants still of it upon there. But I am going to leave well enough alone. Oh, dang. I guess I can't get a patent on that invention, so no problems. Okay, now let's continue with the assembly. Now we're at the point of challenging your dexterity, your ability to control your language, so on and so forth. Right now, I'm going to have to take this thing off. Three things we have to do simultaneously. That has to be there. That has to finagle through the saddle on there, and also has to have a gasket on there. And didn't I mention something about watch oil? I'm going to do that now because I know it's going to be impossible to get this in there otherwise. The smallest little dab of watch oil into those needle bearing holes. Now, I know everybody has watch oil. Go in the kitchen. They're in where the steak knives are. Okay, I guess the best thing to do is get the gasket in place first. Get your retaining ring through there and finagle this through that saddle. You know, everything that I've expected to be a disaster has not come true. I'm putting these in place now because I really want to be stuck with these things. Mainly because I need some way of manipulating this thing to get the threads to mesh. I will begin to insert these needles, because that's going to be another challenge. Already it looks nicer. So even if it doesn't work, it's going to look marvelous. Let's find out where the thread begins. These gaskets will compress a little bit. Probably a lot more than I think. Maybe a pair of rubber gloves would give me some more grip on this. Probably one last thing you want to do is get a toothpick and clean out all the ridges of this knurled ring. Oh boy. Yeah, that kind of doesn't want to be friendly to me. Yeah, this is a challenge, folks. Would be easier if I could get the sound box off the tone arm, but that's not a realistic expectation for this. If nothing else, I've shown you how to do it with the sound box in place. Either that or how not to do it with the sound box in place. Having appropriate tools actually is of great benefit. Okay, you can watch me fumble with this for the next half hour, but I'm actually going to pause the camera momentarily while I express my heartfelt feelings off camera. It's kind of like Chinese checkers. Would I dare suggest that you put a little Loctite on these threads? Actually not. As I said, I'm going to pause the camera and express my deepest regrets for undertaking this thing. I think the issue is more from these gaskets refusing to compress. Okay, so latex gloves saved the day, folks. They gave me enough grip to rotate this thing into place. This gasket, though, this outer gasket wants to urge its way back out. Now, I should tell you, I have encountered two forces that are diametrically opposed. One being that as that diaphragm rotates with the pressure of the gasket and so on and so forth, will tend to loosen that little nut on the back of that cantilever. So, and it breaks it free of the beeswax that actually was not used originally. So I don't know what to tell you about that, other than the beeswax was not a good idea. With that in mind now, what we do is go on to the needle bearings. Start putting those in. I have one semi in place, but not actually in place. Oh, leave me alone! I know the internet's out. Look on your router. Go look at your router. If the lights are out, you have no internet. Got it? Good grief. Oh! Okay, edit the tape. Cut this out. And the idea is to get that cantilever in the center of that yoke. I'm going to back this one off a tiny bit. And snug. Okay, take out my pointed little things before I jab myself. Get a lock washer and a lock nut. At least the lock nut's really polished up nice from the vinegar. And a lock washer there. And with the tightening of this thing, the job is now complete. Ah, that's right. Here it is. Well, there is not a whole lot of clearance between that cantilever and the frame of this retaining ring. How much clearance you actually need is, well, I guess, a debate that you'll have to figure out for yourself. Only one other thing that I would recommend that you do is take a toothpick and go into all this, the grooves of this knurled edge and dig out any garbage that has gotten on there from the last 98 years of atmospheric conditions on this, and I'll get the worst of it out, maybe. Let's get that piano record out. Oh yeah, don't forget the set screw for your the chuck of your cantilever, your needle chuck. Again, we're going to use a soft tone needle, and we're going to play the piano record again. Okay, now replace your tone arm. First off, remove the crank. Lift your motorboard, and it says move lever this way before lowering plate. Your automatic stop lever, move. Okay, it could be over there or there. Okay, just make sure that you move that lever. There are three screws. Replace the three screws. Now I think this one right here, I might need to get a little bit of wood glue because this hole is actually stripped. Oh, the smell, the aroma of petroleum grease. And there's one in the back that's impossible to reach. Impossible for mere mortals, but I'm mortal but not mere. Okay, move lever this way before lowering plate. So drop your motor plate back down. You have somewhere in here. Yeah, there's one here. Yeah, I was right. And one here. Clamp your motor plate back down.
Hear it out.
Yeah, move it up.
There are a few. Oh, it'd be a scab.